Okay, no, actually cannot, cause you're also not looking. Anyway, we are Engineers.SG is the organization that has set up this ridiculous setup where there's like screen lah, then got video lah, then got microphone lah, then got YouTube, got Zoom. It's a lot of effort. I didn't do anything, so thank you Engineers.SG. CA is the logo for a fine gentleman called Lim Chion. He is not here, but it's okay. He has a free pass. He's with us in spirit. Basically he's Sweat King of Singapore. Go stalk him on Twitter. Don't tell him I send you. Moving on. Because meetups have friends, CSS and JS are friends. We even share the same logo, just change color. So Singapore JS has also moved online. So if you want to participate in a slightly more professionally run meetup, please attend Singapore JS. React Knowledgeable is another more professionally run meetup that happens on Fridays. They are also online, so basically everybody's going online because COVID. Anyway, host of the month is the internet. So hi everybody who is joining us from the internet. Oh wait, must say, look, this is the, if you want to choose a globe, a world emoji, there are three to choose from. And because we have chosen the one that is in the correct time zone, everybody. So if you all can see my cursor, Mandy is somewhere here. We are somewhere here. So this is the correct time zone. Choose the correct world emoji for if we want to talk about the world. Moving on. So this month CSS color of the month is Sienna. Ever since, I don't know, 2 months ago, I decided to start talking about random trivia about the CSS color. So this month's CSS color is Sienna. I just lost my cursor. Gun. So Sienna is a earth pigment containing iron oxide and manganese oxide. Those of you who either sleep during your secondary school chemistry or you never take chemistry, basically it rust lah, huh? Then in its natural state is yellowish brown, but when heated, it becomes reddish brown. So clearly depending on your computer screen color range, whatever. For me, I think it's more burnt. So it's like this, like burnt sienna. So it's very ancient pigment. It was used in natural form by ancient Romans. See, I clearly got investigated on Wikipedia, because clearly everything on Wikipedia is true. The name comes from an Italian city-state, Siena, which still exists in Tuscany. It was produced during the Renaissance period. But the first recorded use of Siena with two N's instead of one, which is the city-state name, the first use of Sienna as a color name in English was 1760, but the first appearance as a name color was 19th of August 1985. It was when it was added to the X10 colors database. CSS colors only came in CSS 3, so that's like 2001. But like when that's like random facts that have no benefit to your life whatsoever about the color of the month Sienna. Moving on. This is the agenda. So you all must sit through the 15-minute session that I will shove down your throat. Zoom. So, this is March. It is clearly now the third month of 2020. It's not a great year, but we are still alive, so that's great. So what happened? Firefox 73 has been released, and the most significant CSS related update is overscroll behavior. So it is defined in overscroll behavior module level 1, which was first published in 6 June 2019. And I got taught about this CSS 40. I don't think anybody can remember. So basically, anyway, so what this module does is it for you to control behavior when the scroll position of the scroll container reaches the edge of the scroll port. So let's say you got a container that scrolls inside your bigger window. You scroll, finish, then the browser will scroll the parent. So, but apparently this is sometimes people don't want you to continue scrolling a parent. So this phenomena is called scroll chaining. So what this CSS module does is it lets you control whether you want to continue do scroll chaining or not. So if you are interested or you totally don't know what I'm talking about, you download Firefox 73 and then you also go and try. Then you can tell us. So there's a press release. So moving on, Safari technology preview. The release cycle is 2 weeks. So every month when I talk about this, right, it's gonna be like two versions. Fun fact. Safari, even though Apple very big company, then the campus very big, the WebKit team very small. So basically everything that ships in technology preview is going to end up in stable Safari. So I think it's worth, you know, downloading for a try. I'm going to say something slightly politically incorrect, but like in Chrome Canary, right, sometimes they ship things, then they're like, oh yeah, that was for fun. There's no such thing as for fun WebKit because like they don't have enough people to do for fun things. So anyway, what is fun about the newest release is matches. So if you 1, 2, 3, 4, the fourth point, there's this pseudo class called matches defined in level 4. It has since been renamed to is. So this is going to be fun. They're probably going to alias this or something. So matches and is are the same thing. Whether or not browsers alias it, I don't know. But basically what you can do is you can put a list of selectors into the bracket. So for example, if you put :: is bracket like :.button, .something, .whatever, then all three of them will hit. So it's like a list of selectors, okay? Anyway, go read the spec. It's quite if you want to know how, if you want to see in action, just download Safari Technology Preview. Moving on. In the world of specs, the most exciting thing that happened last month is there's a very let's say widely participated in thread about CSS 4. Okay, the long and short story of it is that there is no such thing as CSS 4. But there is an issue around branding, right? Branding of CSS. So it's a very long discussion thread. You can click on the link and go and see. A lot of people have put in their 2 cents. You can also put in your 2 cents, but don't be that guy who went, how works CSS 4 in React? And then kena downvote by everybody. Like seriously, don't do stupid things. Basically, there was a lot of pros and cons about the term CSS 4. So my personal comment was that if you really want to do how TC39 do ECMAScript, I think the difference is that when you do it for ECMAScript and you do this like ES6, ES7 thing, right? ECMAScript has the benefit of Babel. So most people are like, oh, okay, I will use the newer syntax and then I just Babel all the things. So the code that you ship is actually still ES5. CSS doesn't have the benefit of that. You can say, oh yeah, auto-prefixer. No, auto-prefixer doesn't polyfill. Auto-prefixer only prefix. I personally still like the module system because, you know, I forced it down your throats for about 4 years. But I also recognize that normal people don't read specs. So the long and short of my comment was that I have no comment. It's just more of our opinions. If you scroll through the whole thread like I did, the one fun comment I thought was like, someone proposed using color names as versions because it was like, oh, do we do CSS 4, 5, 6, 7? Or some people say, oh, if we do year, then how? Then somebody just said, let's just use color names. I was like, eh? Actually quite nice, but I don't think anyone's gonna go for it. But it's an interesting discussion. A lot of well-known CSS people have put in their 2 cents, which is quite interesting to read. If you got like 9 bell to do your life, you can go and read it. What else? Scroll anchoring module level 1 working draft release. So this is very new. This is very new, just came up. So apparently, when you load something and then you scroll and then you read content, and then because scripts load very slowly, then you have like content jump, right? So it's very annoying. They are going to expose a CSS property that lets you like anchor it. So that the functionality is that it is to minimize surprising content shifts in the browser. What the spec has is that the spec contains the algorithm of how the browser going to do this calculation. So that's pretty interesting. We also have media queries level 5. So this is tangentially related to what Manny's going to talk about because environment media queries are inside level 5. So, for me, I also want to mention, actually at first this was mentioned as a shameless plug, but then just nice yesterday they released it as a public draft. So now it's no longer a shameless plug, it's an actual piece of news. But anyway, what's included inside there is prefers reduced data media query. Basically, my only contribution to this spec is that I wrote that paragraph. But my friend who's working at Chromium, he's going to actually implement it. So the link inside here is his, sort of like pull request for that. So maybe you'll see in Canary soon-ish. So that's nice. CSS color module level 5 also was released, public working draft release yesterday. So color is now, they're adding color modification functions. So basically, the properties that are now exposed is color mix, color contrast, and there are two proposals being debated on how you modify colors. So this is pretty fun for those of you who do more creative things on the web. And then like a lot of interesting links, because I guess, you know, maybe COVID, then everybody start at home, then do what? Write blog posts. No, I'm just joking. There are also quite interesting code pens that got newsletter. So anyway, I will stop sharing my screen. Mandy, you share your screen, and then yes, everybody pay attention, cause you know, puff. Okay, stop share. Okay, Mandy, go. Yes. Full screen mode, browser, sensors, and API. Wait. So I need to move mine over, is it?
Hang on. I need to check something.
Wait. Like that? What does the stream see?
Hang on. I've pinned a video. Oh, nope. I'm pinned. Shit.
The engineer just said shit, so that's not a good sign. Hang on.
Mandy, could you say something?
Yeah, I am saying things that aren't interesting.
Keep going.
So audio is not going through.
Say something about quokkas.
Coming back, quokkas. Quokkas can be found on Rottnest Island. They're limited to their Rottnest Island, just like Coast Australia.
Oh dear.
Okay, I feel really bad. Anyway, let's just make like yeah. You know, technical difficulties, but let's talk about sensors. Why sensors, Mandy? No, like how do you decide to start playing with like sensors? Cause you know most people don't.
Do you want to check your output?
And then I started playing with variable fonts.
Come on.
And therefore, I started playing with sensors, with different
APIs. So a lot of my demos are text related. Not all of them, but a lot of them are. So that's how I started playing with them, basically, because it was fun.
Nice.
I could control fonts and text and stuff, and it was like, woo, look at how I can change this font based on light or whatever. So that's how I got started with them.
So apparently
you have not given this talk, you know.